man and the candidate for the United States Senate. The story of George Bush is a success story. He was both an outstanding college athlete and a brilliant student. He served his country with valor. A combat carrier pilot, he was awarded the Distinguished Flying Cross and 3 air medals. Today, he serves his industry, his community, and his party. George Bush, the happy family man, is now George Bush, Republican candidate for the United States Senate.
Both George and Barbara Bush campaign hard during the week. On Sunday, however, they try to be with their children after church services at St. Martin's Episcopal Church, where Barbara teaches Sunday school. The Bush clan and some of the neighborhood kids gather in the backyard where the youngsters run up the American and Texas flags. Baseball is the Bush game. In fact, you might call them a Bush League. George says Jeb's going to be a real athlete. And there's Marvin Bush at bat, too. Pretty good. Now watch that Neil Bush slide for home. Get a load of that catch. Not bad for the father of 5 kids. But then George was captain and first baseman of the Yale baseball team, which was the NCAA Eastern Division champ in 1947-48. And he also was elected Phi Beta Kappa and was graduated from Yale in only 2.5 years with a degree in economics. Now that you've seen the Bushes at play, let's listen to George at work.
As a father and a family man, I know you and I share a lot of worries about the future of our state and nation. I certainly hope, and I'll bet you do too, that our children can grow up knowing what freedom really is. For instance, I'd like my children to be able to pray in school if they want to. And I'd like that right to be a part of our Constitution. I want these children of mine, and I want everyone's children, to have the full benefit of our marvelous educational system. And I'd like my children to be ready to spend some time serving our nation's defense effort. Let's hope this will be peacetime service. But at any rate, it will be service for love of country rather than for personal gain. When our children go to work, I want them to know the pride of accomplishment that can come only through the free enterprise system, an economy free of federal controls and bureaus. And most of all, I want them to live in peace and in a nation that stands tall and proud and strong in the eyes of the rest of the free world.
Let's go back now to the Bush family for a few moments. The Bushes, both George and Barbara, really believe that the family which prays together and plays together stays together. This is the Bush family, an American family, a good, healthy family, together and growing under the firm and kindly gaze of Uncle Sam. Yes, we think George Bush is quite a man. A real American, a real Republican, a responsible conservative. The kind of man who should and will be representing Texas in the United States Senate starting next year.
George Bush, the Republican opportunity, the opportunity to win, the opportunity to bring responsible government back to Texas. George Bush, the man for the United States Senate. Vote for George Bush in the Republican primary May 2nd.
Thank you. On the 16th of May, 1989, it's President Bush watching his sons play tennis at the Dirksen Senate Office Building. It's Egan Rigger on camera, Jerry not doing sound, and it's open and we're having a good time.
Dad and John, come on, sonny. Get the elected representatives here. Come on, better get here in the middle. Here's the boss.
Come on, son, you're on our side. Sonny, you're on our side.
Sonny, get over here. Marshall, you're
in
here with your
candy.
Get in here.
Oh. All right.
General
Insel.
Okay, press, can we go over
one
the line
up
on that side?
All right,
there we go.
Over
that side, line up on that side over by the net.
A warm welcome to one of the upcoming bright stars, not only of Florida, but of our country, Jeb Bush.
Thank you, Alec. Thank you, Alec. It is a pleasure to be here among so many friends. It is always a thrill and an honor to have my dad in Miami. When we were upstairs, I think we were trying to count how many times he's been to Miami, and it's impossible to count, but I think he's been to the Omni about 20 times, and he has made a tremendous difference in making the Republican Party grow, because it's been, and a lot of times, to help people at this table and other places get elected. So, Dan, we're happy you're back doing the same thing again. We're also happy because it may have added provided an additive incentive for the most popular woman in America to come. And we're happy you brought your wife and my great mother to Miami, and she is doing so well. It's kind of scary when you're the son of someone. That means from zero all the way up, and you see how a person grows. My mother just today at lunch was quoting French philosophers like and existentialists like Albert Camus, and I can remember when she was yelling and screaming at me for misbehaving. So she's come a long way, and I hope I have too. Of having more prisoners than beds, and having a federal government about ready to lay down the law of the land on the state of Florida, forcing us to release prisoners. And he solved that short-term problem by getting the legislature to quickly convene Governor Bob Martinez.
Throw it up too close. Kenny, how many strokes? I get one a side, I mean, one every hole. You don't get a 3-4?
No.
No, except for that. What do you get? Your winner?
President?
I'll play that.
Who do I have?
President, what are we going to do if Iraq takes over the Kuwait embassy?
Your policy. Boys playing us.
Strategy, huh? Train that ball.
Another. Where's my Mickey?
Go up. Could be what's that?
Just like the Rangers.
Huh? We got a driver. I don't know. It's couldn't afford all of it, huh?
Big, big.
Beautiful.
Tremendous. Want me to bring us back, or? Good place. Good place.
Thank you. That's mine.
How are we gonna play this? Want the Bush boys to take you guys on play?
Yeah, we can do that. I think that'd be great.
All of us get one aside, then the same as we did the other day.
Okay.
I mean,
one aside.
One
I heard that.
No, I mean, one except for the short hole.
What do you mean? You were telling me how well Jeb has been playing.
Well, the boys, this kid, he's just starting the game.
Faith in me, you took my golf swing apart.
I
you haven't put it back together yet.
Cut your hand.
Can
I hit another one?
Yeah. Actually, that may not. Is it up?
Yeah.
No. Down below.
You tell my name.
Here's
big, partner.
Nice and jump.
Big.
What do you mean?
Kenny, I hate to not have you as a partner. I had to dump you. But
I know, I played poorly last time. I understand that.
Play it, but it's
all right.
You're losing.
No, go ahead.
Is that all right, or is it too far?
I would play the other one, yeah.
The first one's okay.
Another one.
No, that's right.
Fine shot, Brett.
Good up.
Sit down. Hit it.
Sorry, Dad.
What did he lie?
4, I think.
Good shot, Brad. Look at this guy. Oh, now. Go ahead.
Boy, that stopped, huh?
No, I'm all right. Come on, partner. Put it in.
You want to hit?
No, I want you to put it in, and I can just bang it in for the birdie.
Look out.
What are you in at?
6.
6-5. Gonna come way over, Kenny?
Yes, it's going to break quick at the left or right. Get up.
Oh!
Beautiful putt.
5-4.
5-4, and we're one down.
Huh? That doesn't make this one too helpful.
Except for 50 center. Except you got a 50 center. Nice bird.
Good putt.
Nice birdie. All right.
Okay.
Read my hip.
Ladies and gentlemen, I have the distinct honor to introduce the President of the United States, my dad. Before I do, Mr. President, Dad, sir, I want to introduce this beautiful crowd to you. This great crowd from Hialeah. These people here, Mr. President, represent what is good and great about this country. They work hard to provide for their families. They want their government to help stimulate the economy when times are tough. They want quality education for their children. They want their streets safe from crime. They want affordable and available health care.
They want their government to work. And they're with you in your struggle to fight against the dinosaurs in Congress to make it happen. Mr. President, Dad, many people here today left countries like Haiti, like Nicaragua, and like Cuba. Seeking freedom in this great country of ours. They know the role our country can play to fight against tyranny and to support freedom. They are proud to support you because you're working to end the long-term suffering that exists in places like Cuba and to help make the dream of a free Cuba a reality. Ladies and gentlemen, damas y caballeros, quiero presentarles a un abuelo fantástico, un padre sin paralelo, un amigo fiel, un hombre fuerte, íntegro y con principios. Ladies and gentlemen, the President of the United States.
Thank you all very, very much.
Cheeseburger?
Hey, Mom.
Behind our new president, and regardless of our differences, all dream.